Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, I'm going to answer frequently asked questions about MacBook batteries. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. You can join us and get exclusive content at MacMost.com/Patreon. So whether you have a MacBook, MacBook Air, or MacBook Pro, it's got a battery. And you probably have some questions about how to use it properly, how to maximize its life, and how to deal with any problems that may come up. So let's start by talking about longevity. How long should the battery last? Well, it varies greatly. Basically between 5 and 10 years. Some of the factors are environmental, how often you use it, and a little bit of luck. After all, the battery is just made up of a bunch of chemicals, and sometimes some last longer than others. It's definitely not unheard of for MacBook batteries to last more than 12 years, but it's also not impossible for it to fail after only about 4 years. I'd say 5 to 10 years for most users, but for power users that are cycling through the battery every day, it's probably closer to 5 years. So how do you see the condition of your battery? You can look at this right on your Mac. You want to go to the Apple menu and About This Mac, then System Report, then look on the left for Power. Then the two things you want to pay the most attention to are cycle count and condition. So what is cycle count and what's a good number there? Well, a cycle is when you start the battery at 100% and you use it all the way down to zero. That's one cycle. You can do partial cycles, so if you go from 100% to 50%, that's half a cycle. Then you charge back up, use it again down to 50%, that's another half cycle. Now a battery should last a certain number of cycle counts before it needs to be replaced, but it depends on the battery. Apple has a list on this webpage here that shows you the cycle counts that each MacBook model should reach. Now for condition, if it says replace soon, replace now, or service battery, that means you've got to get a new battery. Now replace soon means you could probably wait a week or two until it's convenient for you. But the other two, really you should stop using the Mac now, make sure that backup is nice and complete and up to date, and take it in for a new battery. Now to get a new battery, you've got several options. The main one is to take it to Apple. Take it to the Apple Store, make an appointment at the Genius Bar, and tell them that you need a new battery. You can also take it to an authorized service center, so you can look on Apple's website and find one that's near you. Now you could take it to another repair shop. I wouldn't recommend it. Battery replacements aren't that expensive as repairs go, so it's worthwhile to make sure it's done right. If you're completely out of warranty and you go to Apple, it's only going to cost you from $129 to $199. And if that extends your MacBook's life from, say, 6 years out to 10 years, I think it's very much worth it. Now one thing that people notice is that as their battery ages, it sometimes never goes to 100%, or occasionally, even after it's charged, it's immediately at 99%. And Apple says this is actually normal. Remember that battery readings, it's kind of difficult to actually read the amount of power in a chemical battery. So Apple says that sometimes a fully charged battery can show anywhere all the way down to 93% instead of 100%, and it still is perfectly fine as long as the condition of the battery is still shown as normal. So batteries are covered by the standard 1 year warranty and by AppleCare. So if a battery fails or shows service soon, service now in the first year, just take it to Apple and you'll get a new battery for free. And if you have AppleCare, then you'll be able to get a new battery during the length of AppleCare. In addition, if there's a special recall, then you can also use it. So for instance, right now there's some Macs that are a few years old that are part of a battery recall program, and you can get a new battery for free. There are a lot of myths that are out there that are bad information about how to use your MacBook's battery. A lot of this dates back to before the current generation of batteries and for older laptops, and it's just been repeated over and over again by bloggers and news sites. So one of those things is, should you use your MacBook plugged in? And the answer is yes. It's all about cycle count. So if your MacBook is sitting on your desk, have it plugged in. Don't use the battery, you won't go through those cycles. It's perfectly okay to have your MacBook sitting on your desk charged up to 100%. Basically, use it plugged in when it's convenient and use it on the battery when it's convenient. You won't damage your MacBook's battery by having it plugged in for a long period of time. Now this is a really bad one that gets repeated. People say that if you're using the battery, you should run it all the way down to zero before you plug it in and charge it up again. And that's just flat wrong. All you're going to do is run up your cycle count. Where that probably comes from is the old technique of cycling a battery. And the idea here is that every month or so to have your battery charge up to 100%, then run it all the way down to zero and charge it up again. And this somehow calibrates the battery. It's just not something that needs to be done with modern MacBook batteries. So what if your battery isn't lasting that long for each charge? Maybe you're only getting an hour or two out of it. Well, the usual culprit is nothing to do with the battery or the hardware itself, but a lot of times has to do with apps. You can click on the battery icon in the menu bar and it will show you which apps are using the most battery power. And a lot of times there's an obvious culprit, like somebody is playing a game, or maybe you're rendering video, or maybe you're using Chrome and you have a bunch of tabs open. Chrome is notorious for using lots of battery power. Safari is much more efficient. Other tips are decrease screen brightness, go to your energy saver preferences and lower all the settings for when you're on the battery. Make sure you're not using apps that use a lot of power or things like lots of tabs in the browser. And also think of any devices you have connected to your MacBook. Anything you connect like an external drive, a camera, a microphone, that's going to use some battery power as well. So what if you notice your MacBook is swelling? You've got maybe a little bit of a bump on the bottom or the keyboard is starting to bump up. This could mean that the chemicals in your battery now are bad, and this is very dangerous. What you need to do is stop using the Mac almost immediately. Make sure you have a backup. Make sure you're not charging the battery anymore. And then get it somewhere for service. If the swelling isn't too much, a repair center may be able to swap the battery out and you can keep using it. But if it can't be fixed, then you still have to stop using that MacBook immediately and have the battery properly disposed of. So back to longevity. How can you increase that longevity or maximize it? First of all, avoid using your MacBook when it's too hot. Apple recommends that you only use it if it's 95 degrees Fahrenheit or 35 degrees Celsius or less. And I'd say don't even get close to those numbers. And definitely don't charge it in a room where it's that hot. I'd say don't charge it if it's anywhere near 90 degrees or more. And also don't store it in a place where it's going to be hot. And don't store it in a place where the temperature is going to vary greatly. Better to store it, say, in the house than in a garage or a storage unit. Apple has some advice if you're going to store your MacBook long term, anywhere more than a few weeks. Make sure it's charged around 50% and have it powered off. Keep it in a cool place, so less than 90 degrees Fahrenheit, 32 degrees Celsius. And every 6 months or so, turn it on, charge it back up to about 50%, and turn it off again. Apple has plenty of advice and tips for getting the most out of your MacBook battery. You can go to these URLs here to read more about it. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.